Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is with a very warm heart and with great pleasure that I welcome you all from the BYU Jerusalem Center to this romantic evening together with some of the most emblematic pieces of the Romantic period that we are about to enjoy tonight together. And yes, we will start the program tonight with a scherzo by Chopin. Really, a scherzo, we would expect immediately some sort of humorous and funny sort of piece. But Chopin really goes much deeper, and he really like starts all of a sudden to ask existential questions through this scherzo and tries throughout this piece to find some answers as well. And it's a scherzo that gets more and more serious, and you realize that actually in the end he almost says that that life is a joke, that we really like are trapped into this incredible roller coaster of like emotional ups and downs and like extreme sort of reactions. And in the end, the answer is another question. So we will start with this, and I will talk a little bit about the rest of the pieces after.
Thank you.
Okay, now that we kind of reached Chopin's conclusions on some of his existential questions, we're going to move to Schumann in an incredible masterpiece. For me, I think it's from his works, it's the most mystical, spiritual, and like the apogeum of his emotional questioning and this turmoil that it haunted him all his life. I think in this piece really encompasses and is like it's also squeezes out of him the most pure pure emotions. And this, of course, comes with a price, of his mental stability, which was always a little bit problematic. And you will notice in this piece, this incredible, like bungee jumping, almost from his two distinct personalities that he always. This duality that he always struggled with, the Florestan and Eusebius. He even had two characters for himself to understand in which mood he is in certain times of his life. And you will notice this sudden, extremely poetic, sensitive, vulnerable. Almost like a darling character, and suddenly this outburst of rage, of anger, of really choleric emotional outburst that really runs out of control. And this is why I really enjoy to play this piece, because it also almost pushes my boundaries on my personality's extremes, and I always feel like I'm on the edge of the cliff when this raging bull runs out of the music, and then I land really like a feather back in like extreme hot springs of his incredible harmonic language, in this very poetic and this very generous, loving character. So yes, it's going to be quite a journey. This piece, it's 30 minutes. So let yourself be vulnerable and enjoy the ride.
Thank you. Thank you.
quite difficult to talk after this incredible, almost exorcism, that self-exorcism that Schumann did to himself and to also to me. And the following piece basically needs no introduction. It's the Fantasie Impromptu by Frédéric Chopin.
Thank you.
So naturally, after the fantasy, we have to hear a story that happened, and to make it reality. And for this, we have the help of perhaps the greatest storyteller of all time, Franz Liszt, with a Hungarian Rhapsody. It's like most of his works, but especially the Hungarian Rhapsodies are like anthems of joy of life, of extreme hedonistic treadmill, and but also extremely intimate moments as well, not only the sort of flamboyant, everything must be flambé and with a surplus and exaggeration of passion. And in this particular Hungarian Rhapsody, number 12, we get a little bit of cocktail, a little bit of everything. So I thought it's a nice way, after all these deep turmoils of the previous pieces, to end on a lighter note, but still have a little bit of substance. So, Hungarian Rhapsody number 12 by Franz Liszt. Thank you. Now I've been instructed to play an encore. I hope most of the online listeners will agree to it. It's very short. It's 1 minute. It's a waltz, but it has a bit of a Tarantino twist in the middle. So now it was Purim in Israel, so I think it was perfectly suitable for these times. So Chopin, minute waltz, but with a lemon Tarantino twist in the middle. Thank you very much to everyone who followed the online transmission. Thank you to the incredibly beautiful BYU Jerusalem Center, the Mormon University. It's a stunning place. I hope soon we can get to do this live, and I hope to see you all soon again. Have a great evening, and thank you very much, everyone, for your time spent together. Laila Tov.